Dr. Augustin Emmerich is a senior lecturer at the Faculty of Law at the University of Nantes, where he teaches the law of social protection and civil law and commercial contracts. His books include Dr. Schweitzer, an African Icon, and today he'll be speaking on Albert Schweitzer's experience in Gabon. Thank you.
Thank you very much. First, I want to say to thanks for the invitation to take part of this meeting about Albert Schweitzer. Albert Schweitzer is a man who changed really my life during the 20 last years.
Yes.
Yeah. And I'm a little bit afraid because, as you will see with my broken English, it will be very, very complicated for you to understand. But they will translate my text, and you could your understanding will be better when you will read my own text, because it will be not a lecture of this text. I will talk with my heart. To explain a few words. And I want to say that I'm not a specialist of Albert Schweitzer. As you say, I'm professor of law. I'm professor of labor law, social security law. It is very, very far of Albert Schweitzer. But when people ask me, why you wrote a book about Albert Schweitzer? I say always that because Albert Schweitzer was human being, and I'm also human being. And as human being, I have, and as a professor of law, because law is for a people, is for human. I have to understand, especially when I have interest for African law, I have to understand how people think, how people, the customs of the people, the behaviors of people, to improve law in Africa. And law in Europe, I don't need to be anthropologist or sociologist or whatever, but in Africa, you have to know which people, how people think to improve law. And for my interest for Albert Schweitzer start from this issue: how we can improve access to care in Gabon. Gabon is my country. Why Albert Schweitzer? Because myself, I was born in Lambaréné. I was born in Lambaréné in hospital. And in the declaration, when was Albert Schweitzer was, but I know that every child born in Lambaréné, it was Albert Schweitzer. Even Albert Schweitzer was not. my interest for Albert Schweitzer is not linked with this fact, because when I was younger, when I was a student, I was like the majority of young Gabonese people, young African people. I had very bad opinion about Albert Schweitzer, because what we read, Albert Schweitzer was racist, colonialist, and so and so. But since 1944, there was a film made by a Cameroonian, names Basek Bakobio, and I watched this film in Nantes, and I was very, very fascinated by this film. I like this film because Gabon is very, 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 very small country, and when you hear something about Gabon, you are very, very glad, you are very, 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 very happy. And but every year I'm going to Gabon, and I went in Gabon. I was in Gabon during holidays in 1994. And people I met, they are very, very, very critical about this film. In my family, people say that, what is this film? And Her Excellency knows the relation between Gabonese and Cameroonians. And some people say, we know this Cameroonian made a bad film about Schweizer because he doesn't like Gabonese people. He wants to give a bad image of Gabon. And I ask myself, why I like this film and these people that doesn't like it? And I start to interview, to ask these people, but my rule was very, very simple. I decide to talk just with the people who had seen Albert Schweizer, who met Albert Schweizer during his life in Lambaréné. That was my rule to this. But it was not a project for a book. It was just for me, because as I say, interview people is a kind of hobby, because it's not my job. My job is labor law. And 8 years later, I met one of the secretary of Wissenschaft's colleague in Berlin, and we talk about Albert Schweizer. And he asked me, he said, I know that you have a lot of material about Albert Schweizer, you are a specialist of Schweizer. I said, no, I'm not a specialist of Schweizer. But it could be interesting for us if you come to Wissenschaft's colleague to do a research to during 1 year to work about Albert Schweizer. And I say, yes, okay. And my project was, what professor of law, of lawyer, can learn from Schweizer. Because my interest was the organization of hospital. Why Albert Schweizer Hospital in Lambaréné is still today considered like a good example. What was my project in Berlin? And I started to write after Berlin. I started to write a book about what jurist can learn about Schweizer. And I met one of my old friend, old professor, who was in Gabon also. And he said, look at, it is very interesting, your book, but it will be boring for a lot of people, because law is not very interesting for the majority of people. Could you show us who was Albert Schweizer for Gabonese people, firstly? And then you can write what you want about law. And I start again a new book about who is Albert Schweizer, unicorn African. Unicorn African is, this is my talk today. When someone dies, no one cries the same person. I start the days after September 4, 1965. When Albert Schweizer death, there is a kind of in the whole world, because when you consider the newspaper, I read a lot of newspaper, the image of Albert Schweizer was a kind of saint, a kind of good person who helped African people. He was presented like a man of God, very, 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 very kindly presentation. And in Gabon, people say that it was very, very sad because Schweizer was really, really a great and good man. But at the same time, if you consider the newspaper in the 50s and 60s, you you have a lot of papers who are very, very critical. And were very critical against Schweizer, against his hospital. And for this reason, my paper is when somebody dies, yes, together we are crying, we are very sad. But why are we sad? Why are we crying? The reasons are totally different. And I like a Japanese painter, Hokusai. Hokusai has a painting who names 36 views of Mount Fuji. And my methodology is not to show you the truth about Albert Schweitzer, but is just to show a part of Schweitzer. But this part is real, is true, like another part. It is not, I have not the reality about Schweitzer, but it's a reality. And you have to respect this reality also. And my methodology was, as I said, to talk with the people who knew Schweitzer, or like a patient, or they were in this hospital for a few times. And what I learned with these people, and people, during 8 years, I met 65 people. And different people, educated, not educated, women, men, but the main point was, had you seen Albert Schweitzer? Yes, okay, we can talk, because the approach is totally different, because some people in Gabon say to me that for your book, you had to talk with me, because I know a lot of things about Schweitzer, and I have a lot of documents, but it was not interesting for me. Because what is interesting for me, it is the construction, how we built the image of the people, of the famous people. And we build this image, we start from our own culture. And Gabonese view is not Western view, is not French view, is not German view. It is totally different. For example, the day after his death, in Western, the newspapers are talking about Schweitzer, the thinker, the theologian, the philosopher, and more or less the doctor. But the other Schweitzer people were crying in Gabon was not the same. In Gabon, people were praying the doctor. And what means doctor in Gabon? Doctor Schweitzer was doctor, yes, in fact, people call him Dr. Albert Schweitzer, he has a hospital. But doctor is more than physician also, only. Doctor means lot of things. And the figure, the image of doctor still today is very important in Gabon. People doesn't talk about philosopher, reverence for life. It's very important. I don't say that it's not important. Reverence for life, the reflection about civilization, and so on. But no, majority of people are talking about Schweitzer as doctor. And my idea after meeting these people is the construction, the image of Schweitzer, the Gabonese image of Schweitzer. And you have Schweitzer, who is a famous doctor, but why is he famous doctor still today? It's because the image of this image is very, very close of how Gabonese people imagine doctor. And how Gabonese people imagine doctor is not the same way we, you and me, can imagine a doctor. For example, I am professor of university. A great big great doctor is great researcher. But for people in Gabon, great researcher, yes, it's very, very, very interesting. But I think that even in France, because people, when I meet people, they are not interested, yes, to know that he is a great researcher, and so what? But to be a great doctor is not if you are a great researcher. It's another thing. And what I will show here. And the image of Schweitzer, I take for me two important images to explain Albert Schweitzer's success in Gabon. Schweitzer was a doctor, and Schweitzer was white man. And if you don't consider these two aspects, you cannot understand why Schweitzer till today is very, very, very when people talk about medicine, about doctor, Schweitzer is always till today good example. As I say, every year I'm going to Gabon for my holidays or a lot of things with my daughters and my son, and every day we are going to Albert Schweitzer Hospital in Lambaréné to do a lot of things. In 2017, I organized a meeting about the future of medicine in Africa and a lot of events, because Schweitzer is very, very an important part of my life today, because he allowed me to understand a lot of things. And this Schweitzer, who was doctor, who was white, still today is very, very, very people as a kind of respect of this image till today. Despite the fact Schweitzer was white, because people can think that as Schweitzer was white, Gabon is an independent country, we don't need this kind of man who is a projection of colonial period. Schweitzer was doctor, and the image of doctor. The image of doctor, I will start with the Gabonese word, who is Nganga. Nganga, as I said, the main difficulty for me in this research, this work about Schweitzer, was to translate word from two Gabonese language, because I am Fang, and the other language in this region of Lambaréné is Galois, majority, to translate the word from Fang or Galois to French. And now you have another problem to translate this French to English. And the word of Nganga, when you talk about Nganga in Gabon, Nganga is a kind, is healer, is a chief of village, is employer, is lot of he is not just a physician. It is not just a traditional physician. It is very, 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 very huge people. And I think that the success of Schweitzer was considered as not just physician. He was employer because when you was ill, or when you were in hospital, you came with a personal one or people of your of your family. But usually, because people say you don't pay. No, it was not true. You don't pay money, yes, but you have to do something for hospital, because the conception, stress the conception, was hospital for him, not for Gabonese people, but for Schreiber, just what German names the Gemeinschaft, community. Hospital was community, and everybody has to participate for this community. But when I talk with Gabonese people, this idea of community not very, very clear. But no. And if you see Onganga, when I was younger, till my 16 years old, every holidays, I went to with my grandfather in their small village in the center of Gabon, and I was in different Onganga's village. But the Onganga is a people who create his village. He saved a lot of people. He give them land and lot of things. And if you see Schweitzer, you know where is Hôpital Schweitzer, and you know the history of this place. Schweitzer, when the first time he went in Gabon, he was in Andende. Andende is 3 kilometers from the place where Hôpital is today. And later, Schweitzer create his own space for his hospital. And for Gabonese people, this this dimension is like Onganga. Onganga is, and people in their representation, because people I met, they say that, oh, Schweitzer had a problem with another white people, another missionaries, and he decided to let them and to create his own space. But it is their representation. My problem is not to say it's true or not, what they imagine. And they imagine Schweitzer like this kind of people who decide to create his own space, who he will receive people, and in the this part of Gabon, because Her Excellency is here, Gabon is very plural. But in this part of Gabon, the river Ogwe is very important. And in the river Ogwe, I'm from Ogwe. In the river Ogwe, I don't know how people say, how you say in English, débarcadère. I don't know in English.
Landing stage
is very important. When you come somewhere, you say, ah, this is Schweitzer landscape. And it is like Onganga has his own landing stage. And you have these similarities between Schweitzer and Onganga. And the image of Onganga, the nostalgia for Schweitzer as a doctor, is very surprising. When I talk with the educated people, they say that it's not possible, because Schweitzer was not really a good doctor. He was a kind of manipulator and so and so. But the problem is me, as I said, I'm professor of law, but I'm not judge or prosecutor. But the Schweizer the judgment about Schweizer is, for me, is really wrong, because there is a confusion. When people judge Schweizer, which period? Because people talk about Schweizer in 50s or 60s or 60s, but we have to remember that in 60, in 50, for Schweizer died at 90 years old. In 60, Schweizer was 75 years old. And you cannot judge this guy at 75 years old. No. At 75 years old, I think that it will be my situation, we are retired. we are not. In this film, because the film, for example, was the last 20 years of Schweizer life. But during the last 20 years, the people I met in Gabon, they knew that Schweizer was not really, n'était plus, was not a doctor. He was not practicing medicine. No. Every people in Gabon, in Lambaréné, knew this fact. And to say that Schweizer was not the really doctor from this period, for me it's really stupid. Because the issue is not Schweizer was doctor or not, because he was, because to be doctor, it is different from Onganga. To be doctor, you have to be doctor in medicine. And despite the fact of his thesis was about Jesus, what is a kind of curiosity, but Schweizer was doctor in medicine. And he was a doctor. Was him a good doctor? But what is good doctor? What is good doctor? And there is another point of controversy between Gabonese and Western, especially German people. When I was in Germany, people say, people in some German, very interesting about Schweizer, say, Schweizer was the great great physician in Gabon, because he eradicated all illness. And I say, I never listened to this kind of news that Schweizer was a kind of magician. Because for people in Gabon, and for me it's very interesting to understand this relation with Schweizer and to improve Gabonese health system. What these people show that to be a good doctor, it is not just a technical issue, it is not a technical question. Because people think today, to be a good doctor, if you have very good skills, very good machine in your hospital, you have a modern hospital and you are a good doctor. No, that is not true, because human being is not a machine, is not an animal. What Schweizer developed in Lambaréné, it was human relation. And people forget that. I have, for example, my grandmother was talking about Schweizer, and she said, this guy was very curious. Sometimes he come and he sat down, he take your hand and say to you, "Mama, how are you?" In this period, white man who called African people mama, It is very, very bizarre. It is very, 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 very bizarre. And to be a good doctor for these people, it is this relation between human and human. And in the past, because my interest is not just Schweizer, it's very, really access to care. And in access to care, Her Excellency knows Gabon, we had a lot of modern hospitals. The problem in Gabon, in a lot of countries in Africa, is not the infrastructure. We had, but the relation between doctor and patient, it is another problem. And unfortunately, today, there is a lot of doctors who think that it's not very important to develop this part of relation. Who think that the most important is to have good medicine. But no. In the Schweizer medicine, it was completely different. Schweizer medicine was not just a technical, it was another thing, how you serve people. Even in architecture, I'm not an architect, but if you observe Lambaréné Hospital, and you observe, when I was in Gabon, I grew up in a city we called Port-Gentil. In Port-Gentil, we had a huge hospital, very modern hospital, named Polygamba, with 8 or 9 stages. And if you imagine this kind of hospital, and with a good, very, very modern regulation, you say in each room there will be 2 people, and the visit are from 12 hours to 2 p.m. and after 6 to 8 p.m. and so and so. Lambaréné was very open. Lambaréné was very open. You can go at every time till eight hours, because people say that after 8 hours we have to sleep. But the architecture of Lambaréné, you have not a huge building. You have small houses, but Schweizer create a kind of hospital who was adequate with this environment. And it is another explanation of Albert Schweitzer's success, because the hospital, despite the fact that in the 60s you have a lot of critical about this hospital. They say that it was not modern. Yes, I have also critic about this hospital. I'm not a socio, I'm not a fan of Schweitzer really. But my methodology is to understand why these people who are not more stupid, why they consider this man like a good doctor. And why we today can learn from this approach. That is my interest. And for this figure of doctor, and I say that doctor is not just the man who will eradicate the disease. That's not a point. He is the man who will have good reception of patients. That is the main point in Schweizer. And till today, people are saying, you cannot imagine how Albert Schweitzer Hospital was, which kind of reception of people, and so. And yes, it is a construction, but a construction who is based from the human experience. And we have to consider also this experience. And we have also to learn from this experience. It's not just to save us, because I have a lot of my friends, friend in Gabon or in Africa, who say, oh, you know, one guy one day asked me what was the people you met were educated or not. And I answered to him, it's not a problem. For me, every talk, I have to respect every talk. I have to respect every human. I'm not just to respect the intellectual. People who say intellectual, yes, I say that, okay, you are intellectual, but what you know about this reality? What you know about your own reality? Because what it is very interesting today to see that I'm living still in France. But when I am seeing hospital in France, I see that it's a kind, it's a new model of hospital, more open, who receive people all during all day. It is totally opposite at this model in the 70s or 80s, who the main point was hygiene. And today, hospital is a space of life. And what was Schweizer project? But the Schweizer project, it was not Schweizer for me, was not revolutionary. Because it is, what is very funny for me, it is that people forget the past. But the model of hospital in Europe, centuries before, was open space. It is just after Pasteur, where the hospital became a closed space. But before, hospital was very, very, very open. But we in Africa, we consider what is modern. We adopt what is modern. And from 70s, from the 70s, in Gabon, for example, we adopt this modern model, who is visit from 2 hours at middle day, 2 hours. Between these times, what people will do? You will stay in your room. Yeah, in France you have a television, you can watch television. But in Gabon, for your health, it's not a good solution. Yes, Choiset was doctor. But if we want to understand why people still today think that Choiset was a good doctor, another explanation is Choiset was white man. But with this word white is very ambivalent word. People in Western think that white is the issue of color of skin. It's not true. White, we know that it's a construction in Middle Age in Europe. In Europe, the colors, the development of colors for Middle Age when and in antiquity, we have not a distinction between white, black, and so people of, for example, African, well, people from Africa. Saint Augustine was not black, but was African. You say, African. But for me, Middle Age, we have a new category, was black, yellow, white. But in our languages, For this research of Schweizer, I asked a lot of people from Angola to Senegal. There is no people who consider that the name of color of skin is the same the name of the color. To be clear, in my language, Fang, white, color. White is fun, fun. White people is dan. In Congo, in Lingala, white color is Pemba. Pemba is the same of the bread. But white people is Mundele. Mundele or Ntanga in Gabon, in farm or in Miene is Otangani. What means Otangani? Otangani comes from the verb Otangas is to pay. To pay. To calculate. It's people who and we have a proverb who say that white people pay God to be the king of the world. And Ntanga is people who need to calculate, who need to pay, because when he came somewhere, he will ask you, how old is you? How many children have you? How many? It is the representation of white people. It's men who calculate and who pay. And me, for example, when I'm going in Gabon, and it's very funny for my for my daughter. People say, ah, white man is coming. And white is not a color of skin, it is a social statue. And Schweitzer, the success of Schweitzer, because when I say he was a white man, people will think about racism and no. But about that, he was a white man. But white man is different of we. Because we don't name ourselves black. I have often a joke with my student in Nantes. I say to them always that when I was in Gabon, I was human being. When I grew up in Gabon, I was man being. And I became black people arriving in France. In France, I'm black, I'm African. But in Gabon, I'm a human being. I'm not considered like African or black, no. And with white man is different of African man. And Schweitzer was white, but at the same time, white man like the other white man, and at the same time, because it is the what I learned, and it was one of the guy I told he names Janvier. One of these guys say, you know, my friend said, Schweitzer was not a devil, was not a god. He was human. He was human. And human, you have dark parts and you have very likeness, like parts, and you cannot separate these two parts. And Schweitzer was at the same time really a symbol of white man. And a symbol, a white man, a white like any other, Schweitzer was, for example, when you read what Schweitzer wrote, it is not totally different from the other white people. Schweitzer was an approach, we consider that white man is the primacy of Western. And even in vocabulary, if you read Schweitzer in German, you have word like primitive and so, but for me, it is not a joke for me, because it is the vocabulary of this period. But it is not good or it is vocabulary of this period, and we have to consider that Schweitzer was a man of this period. who consider that white are very superior of the other people, and the colonization is to give civilization to for African people. Yes, it's true. And in hospital, Choiseul was also like a kind of dictator, because when you speak in French, Choiseul, the other doctor, people say doctor or for women, madame, mademoiselle, Choiseul, people name him grand doctor, grand doctor. And I have some people who say that sometimes when people say bonjour docteur, he say et l'adjectif grand. C'est et l'adjectif. The great doctor, the number one, was Choiseul himself. And white man, like any other white, is this morning I the presentation of Predrag Csikópakhél. I don't know if the pronunciation is good. Choiseul as like an intellectual. For me, what you said this morning was very interesting for me, because I think, wow, this guy was an intellectual, and he didn't talk about African. He was in Africa. He didn't care, take care of the African wisdom, African things for folks. No, it is very, very, very far of him. And sometimes, if you read Schweitzer, it takes only anecdotes. It takes takes anecdotes about Gabonese people, but he didn't present them like a people who can have really fought construction for their fault. And Choiseul at the same time was not white like other white. Choiseul was not. I have a very short example. 6 years later, I was invited in Paris to talk by a small feminist group to talk about the relation between Choiseul and women. And I they sent me an invitation, and I was very happy to be invited by women to talk about Choiseul. But I just write, it is a big pleasure for me, but it will be very easy, because I will need just 3 minutes to talk about this. Say why? Because I have nothing to say about Choiseul and women. And they were very surprised, because during perennial colonial relation between white men and African women, you have literature, very, very, very important, big literature, big about this kind of relation, because African was a kind of a space when white man can take women as he wants. But Choiseul, the people I met in Lambaréné, and that was the reason of people was very angry about against this film, because Choiseul was presented like a guy who had a relation with African woman. People say, never, Choiseul, relation with the woman, never. He was not like another white. He was not like another white. And if you consider the Albert Choiseul life, the issue of women was not very important, because his woman, for example, who was more a friend his best friend, and he was in a separate room, you know, in Lambaréné. Schroeder was not very interesting, and he was, for this reason, he was not white like another, but he was not like black, white like another, for another reason. If you consider, if you read the sermons in Lambaréné, the sermon has very, for me, has very, very precious, very, very interesting. In the sermon, Schroeder was a pastor, but pastor, Protestant. But Schroeder was not like the other missionary. He was not, when he talked to people, he was not considered people like bad behavior, bad costume, bad people, and so and so. Schroeder said, I will be example for them, but I have to respect what they are. And for example, what is so surprised, Schroeder never condemned polygamy. He considered that polygamy is necessary today, but in the future, maybe they will change. But for missionary, it is very, 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 very surprised, because all of the missionary consider that polygamy is very, very bad, it's not conform to the religion. And Schroeder also, that is a very, very, very interesting point, because I have a lot of controversy with my Gabonese or African friends when I say that the Schroeder I know, it is not your Schroeder. Why? Because I consider Schroeder, and the people I meet consider Schroeder in his period. And in his period, they compare Schroeder with other white people who were at the same time in Gabon. And when they compare Schroeder with these other people, with other white people, Schroeder was a kind of saint. Because in Gabon, we had a very, very... I listened to two examples. One guy who was in Jolé, working in gold, and so, who is very, very cruel. And in Lambaréné, where I had an anecdote, one of Schroeder worker had a ceremony after his mother's death, and in Gabon, after the death, we have a big ceremony during several days, you make a lot of noise, and one white who was very close of these people considered that it was enough, and came with his gun, and Schroeder was very furious. Very furious, he decided to not receive the workers of these white people, because this guy doesn't respect the African people. And in this period, a white man who can defend African people against another white, it was very, 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 very curious. And I have a lot of examples to show that, yes, he was white, he was totally white, because Schroeder was not like some white people. When they came, they say, I will become African, I will become black. No, you don't, he considered that it is very, very inferior. But at the same time, I think that is the complexity. At the same time, he had a big respect, not in the sense of reverence or Erfurt von der Leben, respect in Gabonese sense, to consider that what you are doing, I don't know it, but let it. Okay. It's not to consider that you are my equal. No, let it. And people appreciate that, because In fact, we today we consider that people want to be together, want to live together, want to live together. Not, but Schroeder people, I met them, say, ah, Schroeder was very great, was very, very interesting because he let us in peace. What I want to share with you, sorry for my broken English, because when you are talking in another language, you cannot explain really what you have in your head, but I hope that everybody understands a little bit what I want to explain. Thank you very much.